Tired of typing your blog posts, social media captions, or video outlines? Then open up a new Google Doc and give Google Voice typing a go. I bet you will love it as much as I do. And I'll show you how to get up and running with it in this video. Before we start voice typing, let's ensure that you're all set up for success. So, number one, use Chrome as your browser as all other non-Google browsers are not supported. Number two, ensure that the Chrome browser can access your microphone. The process differs depending on whether you use a Mac or a Windows-operated computer. But in general, you can find it under the privacy settings. You want to allow apps like Google or Google Docs to access your microphone. I know this is quite technical, but stick with me to avoid frustration later on. And I'm curious, have you tried voice typing before? How did it go? Leave me a comment below. I'd love to hear your story. Now over to number three. Ensure that you've given websites access to your microphone. Now to do that within Chrome, click the three little dots at the top right corner here. Then go to Settings. Then select Privacy and Security. Go to Site Settings in the middle of the page. Scroll down. Then click the microphone link in here. And confirm that sites can ask to use your microphone. Also, check that Google Docs is not listed in the not allowed section down here. It's okay if it's not officially listed under the allowed section here, but it needs to be not in this section here, okay? Now, number four, make sure that you use a headset to pick up the sounds correctly and that it's not set on mute. Done all four? You're good to go. By the way, I'll also put a link to a fantastic support document in the video description below. Now, open up a new doc. You can do this the old-fashioned way by clicking through your drive or simply typing in docs.new or doc.new. And we're good to go. Now, if you have multiple Google accounts, just ensure that you're in the correct account by checking the profile in the top right corner here. Go to the Tools tab. Then choose Voice Typing. Before we get started with the voice typing, click the little icon here and make sure that you've selected the correct language. This is very important as all the commands later on are obviously in your language. Now Google is doing a great job adding languages, so I hope yours listed here. Click on the microphone and now you can see that you actually need to allow the microphone to have access to Google Docs. If you're here, simply click allow and obviously not block and you should be good to go. To start with the voice typing process, click the microphone icon and then start talking. Now to get started, let's open up the voice commands. See all voice commands. Stop listening. That already worked really well. Now you should see a list with all the commands. Go through it at your own leisure, take your time, print it out and put it next to you until the commands are second nature to you. I've also linked a link to the command list in the description below this video. Now, to demonstrate some basic functionality, let's do a little bit of a voice typing demonstration. And for that, I'll put my headset on. Troubleshooting guide. New line. Google Voice Typing. New paragraph. Let's make sure that you're all set up for success by checking those four things. M-dash, new paragraph. Create numbered list. Use Chrome as your browser, as all other non-Google browsers are not supported as of right now. Full stop. New line. Ensure that the Chrome browser can access your microphone. Full stop. This process is different depending on whether you use a Mac or a Windows operated system. Full stop. But in general, comma, you can find it under the privacy settings where you want to allow apps to access your microphone. Full stop. New line. Check that you've given websites access to your microphone. Full stop. New line. make sure that you use a microphone close to your mouth to pick up the sounds properly and that the microphone is not muted. Full stop. New paragraph. New line. If you need more detailed instructions on completing the above steps, I will put a link in the description below this video, full stop. Now let's do some editing and formatting, full stop. Select Troubleshooting Guide. Apply title. Unselect. Select Guide. Title case. Unselect. Select Google Voice Typing. Uppercase. Unselect. Select Success. Lowercase. Underline. Unselect. Go to End of Document. New Paragraph. I hope this brief demonstration was helpful. Full stop. Stop listening. Pretty cool, huh? Is it perfect? No. There's still some manual grammar, spelling, and formatting corrections to do, but considering I have a strong accent, I think it worked pretty well. By the way, yes, the editing and formatting commands can sometimes be a little bit overwhelming and tricky. The good thing is that you can still use your keyboard or mouse or trackpad to jump to any word or section and finish your editing while the app is still listening and waiting for you to continue. Now, when writing your next postscript or email draft, give it a go. The more you use it, the faster you will get things done, especially if you rather talk than type. Happy voice typing. And if you're interested in other tools I use in my business and the how-to, watch one of my other videos or hop over to my website where I'll share my favorite tools on one page. See ya!